Oh, The letter to the Hebrews. Jesus offered one sacrifice for sins and took his seat forever at the right hand of God. Now he waits until his enemies are placed beneath his feet. By one offering, he has forever perfected those who are being sanctified. The letter to the Hebrews identifies Jesus as the great high priest. It's the only place in the scriptures, the New Testament, that specifically identifies Jesus with his title, though of course the Gospels portray Jesus as doing priestly work of healing, of restoring to health and life, and of offering the great sacrifice of himself. So in the book to the Hebrews, Jesus is specifically identified as the high priest. We know that the great act of Good Friday was to offer himself, the Lamb of God, freely, willingly. He was the priest who made the offering on the altar of the cross. Then we read in the scriptures that there is a passage of 40 days, and Jesus then ascends to heaven, and we are told forever sits at the right hand of the Father. We're likely to think that the ascension is kind of a retirement ceremony. The Lord did what he priestly role of Jesus has two phases. One is that of offering the sacrifice of himself freely to the Father for the salvation of humanity on the cross. The second phase is the phase that Jesus entered into in the Ascension. The Ascension was the prelude to the second fulfilling of the priestly role. That is simply to continue the work of calling, of exhorting, of forgiving, and of healing, and of pushing forward, and of preparing his people for the great day of resurrection. The paradox of it all is that he has done so much, so perfectly, so magnificently, and offered us an unbelievable gift. No man could ever imagine that of sharing in the glory of God for all eternity in the kingdom of God. If we were to hear it, we would hardly believe it. And yet he has to come and exhort us, plead with us, beg us to enter into this realm of the risen life. And then he has to continue that work within the hearts and souls, purifying us of the attraction to sin and of deepening the virtues that he himself implants through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. So as we are moving now from Easter, the gift first experienced by Jesus in the resurrection, the gift of the Father to all his children, we now get ready for the second phase, which is the phase in which we live, in which through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the Lord completes his priestly work by continuing to purify, to strengthen, and to draw us into the kingdom of his Father, worthy of sharing forever the risen life.
This day all generations will call me blessed. Victorious King, hear our prayer.
Light and salvation of all peoples, send into our hearts the fire of your spirit as we proclaim your resurrection.
Victorious King, hear our prayer.
Let Israel recognize anew her longed for Messiah, and the whole world be filled with the knowledge of your glory.
Victorious King, hear our prayer.
Keep us in the communion of your saints, and grant us rest from our labors in their company.
Victorious King, hear our prayer.
You have triumphed over death, your enemy. Destroy in us the power of death. We may live only for you, victorious and immortal one.
Victorious King, hear our prayer.
Savior Christ, you were obedient even to accepting death, and were raised up to the right hand of the Father. In your goodness, welcome your brothers and sisters into the kingdom of your glory.
Victorious King, hear our prayer.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, author of all truth, a people once in darkness has listened to your word and followed your Son as he rose from the tomb. Hear the prayer of this newborn people and strengthen your church to answer your call. May we rise and come forth into the light of day to stand in your presence until eternity dawns. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.